And let me first off start off by saying thank you all for being here this morning at this morning's press conference. Mayor Thaddeus Kirkland, and I'm joined by my colleagues on council, Councilman William Al Jacobs, Councilwoman Portia West, Councilman Nafis Nichols, Councilwoman Elizabeth Williams, and City Controller Edith Blackwell. We're also joined by our Police Commissioner Darren Alston and our Fire Commissioner, Commissioner Thomas. I just want to thank all of you for being here today. We know what we're here concerning, and that is the tragic accident and loss of lives on early Sunday morning yesterday. First of all, we all want to send out our prayers to the families of the men who lost their lives on the tracks here in Chester yesterday. Amtrak workers, my understanding is that they've been workers for quite some time, employed for quite some time by Amtrak. And so our prayers go out to their families and their loved ones. Our prayers also go out to the operator of the train. That had to be a very devastating and horrific event for him or her. And to the passengers and who were injured and passengers who were on board and to the co-workers of the men who lost their lives. I do want to provide a special thanks to the church and the pastor of Trainer United Methodist Church. As my understanding is that is was the housing or staging place for many of those persons, all of those persons who exited the train safely and were able to go to Trainer United Methodist Church to find refuge and help and prayers. Also, it was a staging place for many of you in the media. And so we want to send out a special thank you to the pastor and congregation of Trainer United Methodist Church. I also want to acknowledge the excellent work of our first responders, our police officers and our firefighters who were on the scene, not just our Chester police officers and firefighters, but surrounding volunteer fire companies and police officers came in to assist us during this very tragic event. As for me and council, our hats go off to them because of the cooperation, because of the working together, because of the excellent service that they provided during this time of need. I can only imagine being in their shoes, having to go and witness what they have to witness on a daily basis as first responders. And so I want to applaud them for their courage. I want to applaud them for their hard work and their commitment to doing what they do on a daily basis, and particularly on this Sunday. As you all know, this is an ongoing investigation, an investigation that's being done by the National Transportation Safety Board. And so we are in support of their investigation. We, just like you, are waiting to find out all of the particulars. We are waiting to find out the reasons. We are waiting to find out further information. We have been fortunate here in the city of Chester to be under the leadership of Commissioner Thomas, who has been working very closely with NTSB. And as we move forward in our investigation, there'll be more information coming forward. I want to send out a special thanks. They've made their calls and their appearances. Congressman Robert Brady has been here on yesterday down at the accident scene, as well as myself and members of council. And Congressman Brady has offered his support in any way that he can be supportive to not only the city of Chester, but to Amtrak and the families of the victims. Also, we received a call from our governor, Governor Tom Wolf. And Governor Wolf expressed the same sentiments. In his call, he said, how can he be of help? He's just a phone call away. He wants to make sure that he makes himself available during this tragic situation. And so we appreciate our political leaders in Washington and in Pennsylvania, our governor, reaching out to a small city called Chester with their support. This is hard. This is hard. It's painful and it's tragic. But hopefully at the end of the day, we will all have learned something to make our railways safer for workers and pedestrians alike, but we'll all learn something about people coming together and unifying and working together during tragic times and horrific times. Once again, my hat goes off and our hats go off to our first responders. They did an awesome, excellent job, and we greatly appreciate that. Understanding that this is still under investigation, we will now entertain any questions that we can, or my commissioner can answer.
Good morning. As far as we know, yesterday the operator was the last to exit the train, and he was able to walk. He was in good condition. He had a minor leg injury, and he was transported to the hospital.
How many remain in the hospital?
How many remain? That I do not know.
Can we anticipate the identities of those who were killed to be released anytime today or soon?
That's also an Amtrak issue as far as confidentiality and next of kin, so we would have no control over that.
Can you describe the range of injuries that you saw or that the responders saw?
Well, when the initial accident occurred, my men entered the train to triage the most injured, to have them set out to the ambulances. Most were able to be put into the gurney or carried out, so there were any major injuries as far as we could tell from a responder's point of view. So there was nothing overly major.
So most people were ambulatory, they could get out of the room?
Most people could, yes.
What will specifically be done today? Is there any further investigation?
Today, Amtrak is continuing to try and open their tracks. NTSB is continuing their investigation work and in tandem with Amtrak.
Will the train be moved today?
I do not know.
Anything about the moments leading up to the crash, what the backhoe was doing there in particular, anything, was there working, why was there work being done, was it from the storm, or was it routine maintenance, any of that?
We do not know. We only responded after the impact occurred, so we have no idea what was taking place prior. If you could, I would just like to reiterate what the mayor said and thank the first responders that responded to the incident, and those in the other boroughs, in particular Aston Township, Company 17, Delaware County Emergency Management Team. I would like to thank all of them. They did an excellent job. The Chester Fire Department did an excellent job. They helped us mitigate the situation, and it was really well handled, and it made the best of a worse situation.
Have you had any issues on that stretch of tracks in recent history?
Not in my career, not that I can recall, no.
Are there any thought process? I mean, this was a tragic incident, but if you notice along that track, there are so many homes. And I mean, had this been worse, it could have had a bigger impact. Is there any safety plan in place that deals with the residents who live in that area?
Yes, Delaware County Emergency Management Team, we train constantly on rail responses. That was one of the governor's key points when he got in particular the BOC crew that's being transported. But when we do our exercises to prepare for incidents on the rail line, we prepare for everything. So it has always been under consideration, and we've considered all the rails that run through Chester.
Are there emergency systems in place? I mean, warning systems, sounding? I've talked to neighbors.
sounded when trains are passing. Is that something that exists in Chester?
I'm not sure about how the train standard operational procedures are for their warnings and their audible sounds, but we have no control over that.
How did you get the first 911 call?
It came through dispatch, Delaware County dispatch.
And who made the initial call? I mean, what was like the, can you break it down for us? What was the timeline?
We received our initial dispatch at 7:54 in the morning. Vehicle accident on the Amtrak rail lines. And we understood that a passenger train had hit a backhoe. That's how it came across to us.
How does that get to you? How does that dispatch get to you?
From the 911 call center. We receive all our calls, including fires and accidents, through them.
So somebody called 911?
That's correct.
Do you know who that person was?
I do not know.
Do you know, were you given a location on the tracks, a track marker indication, or just a street address?
Initially, we were given 6th and Booth streets. When we got there, which was the area of the initial impact, upon further investigation, we found that it extended into Trainer, where the passenger train finally stopped. So we established incident command at 6th and Booth, where we sent people to, which ended up being 9th and Langley streets in Trainer. And there we were able to offload the passengers, and just so happened the Trainer United Methodist Church was right there, and they accommodated the incident.
Your knowledge, was this a stretch of track that was undergoing any kind of routine maintenance in recent weeks or months?
I'm not aware of that.
Could you say and spell your name for me?
Yes, Commissioner Travis Thomas, TRAVIS, last name THOMAS, City of Chester Fire Department.
Obviously, when we all heard the story, we had echoes of the derailment last year. So when your first responders were getting to the scene, they must have been imagining something as horrific as that. While this was tragic, I mean, can you speak to the fact that it could have been a lot worse, the passengers being really hurt?
Yes, we try to learn from our past lessons, and that was the first thing in our mind when we get a train accident. It didn't particularly come in as a train derailment. It came in as an accident, a train striking a backhoe. We later found out it was a passenger train. So we always have that idea in the back of our mind as far as what we're going to be confronted with. Well, we also have the incident command system, and we have a routine in place with Delaware County where the surrounding boroughs will come and assist because they know the magnitude of the incident, and that way we could help mitigate it a lot sooner. So it was a thought, and we did activate it so that we could accommodate the worst.
So the call came at 7:54. When did the first responders get there?
I'm not certain, but it would have to be within 3 to 4 minutes because our firehouses are located so that we can reach any residents in the city within 3 to 4 minutes.
Were you guys first on the scene?
We were.
Thank you. And just to reiterate, although this was a horrific tragedy, because of tragedies, more times than none, lessons are learned. More times than none, corrections are made. As you use for an example, the train derailment in Philadelphia now have safety mechanisms in place so that such tragic occurrences don't happen again. After this investigation, that is our hope and our prayer. And once again, our prayers go out to the families of the individuals who lost their lives. We want to thank all of you for being here, and as we get information, we will share that with you.
Mr. Mayor, I just have one more question. Some might say that especially after that derailment last year, that was much more tragic, that those safety mechanisms would be in place, that there were some implemented, but what more would you say that you could do now?
Well, it's hard to say right now because it's still an investigation. When we find out exactly what happened, then we can project or look at how Amtrak makes changes and how we follow up on those.
Do you by any chance know if the two people who were killed are local Chester residents or from the area?
The only information we had as of the accident that was that they were non-passengers on the train. They were not passengers on the train. That's all we had.
Thank you so very much, and we will keep you updated as we are updated. Thank you. We appreciate you being here.
Thank you.